In this video, I'm going to show you how to collect and analyze industrial data using Aveva Insight.
So for this demo, I'm going to use Node-RED to collect sensor data from my industrial controllers and then use Aveva Insight to dig into the data. So this is the architecture that I'm using in this demo. I've got a Groove Epic controller that is generating temperature sensor data on one of its modules. And then I've got a legacy PEC controller that is generating fuel level data simulated by a potentiometer analog input. So what I want to do is to collect this telemetry data and send it to the Aveva Insight cloud-based analytics platform. So to do that, I'm going to use Node-RED. The Groove Epic controller natively runs Node-RED, so I'm going to use that to access its temperature module. For the legacy PEC controller, I'm going to run Node-RED on my Windows PC and then use a Modbus package to collect the potentiometer value. And then I'll send both telemetry data points to the Aveva Insight platform. That is possible because Aveva Insight exposes its endpoint using a REST API. So I'll simply use HTTP to post a JSON object over a secured channel.
Okay, so here I've got my Groove Epic controller. I'll be collecting sensor data from this temperature probe connected to this temperature module. And then here I've got my PEC controller, and I'll be reading this potentiometer value via Modbus TCP.
Okay, so I'm going to log into my Aveva Insight platform. Okay, so now once I'm logged in, the first thing that I'm gonna do is to define a data source. So to do that, I'll go to my administration page. And then I'll click on the plus sign to define a new data source. And then I'll select the CSV/JSON. Okay, so I'll call my data source demo plant. Okay, and then I'll click OK. Okay, so once my data source is created, Aveva Insight provides me with the endpoint URL and an authorization token for me to use when sending data to this platform. Okay, so I'll copy the two and then head over to Node-RED. Okay, so right now I'm on the Node-RED platform running on my Groove Epic controller. So I've put together this flow. So here I'm using the Groove Epic controller's Node-RED package to read the temperature value after every 3 seconds. And then here I'm using a function block to build my Aveva Insight message. So this is a JSON object, and then I'm calling that object temperature and then assigning it the value of my temperature sensor. And then I'm bundling all of that with the ID and the timestamp for Aveva Insight platform. And then here I'm making sure my message is in JSON format. And then here I've got a function block where I'm adding authorization to my message by putting the authorization key that was generated after I created my data source. And then finally, I'm using an HTTP request node to post that record to Aveva Insight platform. So also, this is where I put the endpoint URL which was generated on creating the data source. Okay, so now I'm on the Node-RED running on my PC, and then here I'm building my Aveva message. And the rest of the nodes are the same as those for sending the temperature to the platform. Now let's head back to Aveva Insight and see if data from both our controllers is getting into the platform. Okay, so we're back on Aveva Insight. So I've actually let it run for some time so that we could collect a sizable amount of data. So as you can see here on the last update that we have been getting data, and we can also go into the history of the data source to see each record that has been received. So as you can see, we're still getting our data coming through within seconds. Okay, so now let's go to our homepage and see how we can be able to dig into this data. Okay, so your first point of entry into analyzing your data using Aveva Insights is through this search interface, where you can literally search for any tags or data sources by name, and it will pull up any information related to that tag or data source. pretty much like how you'd use Google to search for stuff. So if I type in the name of the data source, so these are our two tags here. So I could choose to explore the tags individually, but I'll explore all the tags in my demo plant by clicking the data source here. Okay, so first of all, here to the left is showing me the total number of my tags on the demo plant. And on the main window here, which is your status board, you can see the current value of my tags for fuel level and the temperature. And then there's an indicator here to show if they are on an upward or downward trend. So if I turn my potentiometer and then refresh, you see the value going down there. If I turn it up again, you see the value is now on an upward trend. So if you happen to have a lot of tags perhaps and you want to focus on a few, you can go to the tag section here and then you can switch tags on and off depending on what you're looking for. And then you can also check out details for each tag by using this little arrow here. And then when you go here, you can choose your chart style. So you can view your line chart. Or you can view a column chart. And then under column chart here, you can also choose to display your data in aggregates of maximum, minimum, last, total, and also select the time frame here. And if you go to your line chart, you can select your time span here at the bottom. So I'll choose to view data from the last hour. So obviously having your charts superimposed like this can help you find correlations. And then if you find something unusual, you can add a comment to it by clicking this comment box and clicking the point of interest. And then you can share that with your team. And then you can also set an alert to be notified in case this happens again by clicking on this bell here and then dropping it on the chart. And then here I'll say if the fuel level is greater than 80. So, and then if this hourly combination of sensor data is something that interests me, I can actually save it for later. And then I'll call it hourly sensor data. And then I'll assign keywords to it. And then I'll save it. Okay, and then you can also go to the graphic composer option here. This will allow you to overlay your tags on top of a graphic of your choice, which could be your plant layout. Upload your graphic here. And then I'll drag my temperature tag to where my sensor is positioned on the physical device. And then I'll save this. And then when you go back to the home page, so as you can see here, the dashboard is suggesting content for me based on my activity in exploring the data. So this section here is your news feed, which is whereby Aveva Insights learns your data and then it starts to give you some unusual and interesting events in your data. Okay, so this was basically meant to give you an introduction into analyzing data using Aveva Insight, but there's so much more that you could do with your data on this platform. I would certainly love to hear from you, so please leave a comment down below, and thanks for watching.